So this is a bio-inspired robot project. We are doing a flying squirrel robot. So our robot's gonna be have like two basic modes. Like one is a hopping mode, like it's gonna be hopping on the ground. The other one's a gliding mode. So whenever the robot detects like a cliff, it'll jump and then deploy the wings so it can like gliding safely to the ground. That's basically our project. At the beginning of the semester, we go to the zoo and we found out there are like several like animals landing on the ground with their tail, and then we looked at the video like for flying squirrel. It does not only use their tail, it also used the wings to like control the direction. So that's why we think this is kind of interesting to mimic. So the most challenging part of this project is the mechanical design, because the simulation part is always go different from like the actual design, because like in the simulation it's always ideal, like all of the parameters are preset. So but in reality we try like different dropping tests. Sometimes they flipped, sometimes just not going the way we want, even though we are doing according to our simulation. So we just like do like redesign the robot based on our experimentation. So hope to see like a better result like in the next few days. At the beginning of the semester, we are searching for literatures about flying squirrel. And it turns out flying squirrel have fairly simple structure, so it's easier for us to like mimic. And after that, we're doing some CAD design. So first, we start with conceptual designs. For the conceptual design, we're just basically like drawing out how much degree of freedom we need, what is the deploying mechanism. They're all like conceptually designed. So, and then we turn it into CAD model to see if it actually fits. After the CAD model, we do the simulation based on the CAD model, like to see like based on the speed, based on the mass, if it can safely land it on the ground. After the simulation, we order parts and assemble things, test, and see the problem it is, and then redesign and test. That's basically our process right now. We're having a really good time working together, actually. I mean, everybody doing it, their own job, and we're keep on track, and we're keep on the time schedule, pretty much. So yeah, I'm having a pretty good experience this time. It's just like a really novel experience for me. So I've done some other like robot design and like a vehicle design project before. They are all pretty have like a, they all have like a set goal. It's like, you know what you're gonna do. It's not like a research project. For this one, it's like, you have to make your own research questions. You have to make your own objectives. And based on that objective, you're gonna see how much you can achieve. That's really like a novel experience, like I said. Like I've never done something like this before. It's pretty interesting for me.